Hello, my name is Dr. Kayleen Asbo. I am the cultural historian and pre-concert lecturer for the Santa Rosa Symphony's upcoming program on December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. I'd like to invite you to join me at Weill Hall at the Green Music Center, where guest conductor Jayce Ogren will lead the Santa Rosa Symphony in a program that is as bright and brilliant as Italy, a land of paradox where sacred yearning meets secular revelry. Our program opens with the William Tell Overture, composed by the most popular Italian opera composer of his day. Though the opera was written in French and it premiered in Paris, the music from the William Tell Overture received its most notoriety from an American TV show, The Lone Ranger. We'll turn from the secular world of opera and TV shows to the hallowed, sacred halls of a convent school for our next piece of music. Though most people know Vivaldi for his gorgeous violin concertos, very few people realize that they were written to showcase the talents of the foundlings, the girls, who were part of the convent school of Ospedale della Pietà. Vivaldi, who was himself an ordained priest with wild red hair, was the music director for this school. The girls achieved enormous international acclaim for their musicianship. And the piece that we're going to hear, the Gloria, is a work that celebrates the sacred world. The lyrics come from a 4th-century text that celebrates a part of the Mass. As we listen to it in the Green Music Center, I want you to imagine going back in time to a church lit by candlelight. You might be able to hear the strains of the music, but you wouldn't be able to see the performers because it was not thought fitting for women to perform on stage. The girls were hidden behind a filigreed screen. Angels in silhouette, they were called. In this joyous work, set in the triumphant key of D major, we hear the bright brilliance that Vivaldi is so well known for in his concerti. This brilliant orchestral and choral writing is intermingled with the exquisite, soulful sensibility of solo passages that evoke an aria. The finale of Vivaldi's Gloria is truly glorious, as one layer of sound rises on another in an explosion of joyous polyphony. After intermission, we'll turn to the wanderings of a secular romantic hero, Hector Berlioz. Berlioz had made his fame with the Symphony Fantastique, a work which unfolds a story of a love-sick hero. at one of this early performances of the Symphonie Fantastique, the violin virtuoso Niccolo Paganini was in the audience. He was so enamored of the music that he heard that he went to this young composer and proposed that they collaborate. One of the things that had enchanted Niccolo Paganini in the Symphonie Fantastique was its famous march to the scaffold that depicts the hero climbing up and having his head chopped off with a guillotine. Perhaps it was this that inspired Paganini to suggest that the work that they work on together be based on the life of Mary, Queen of Scots, who herself was beheaded. And so Hector Berlioz set to work in order to showcase Paganini's new Stradivarius viola. Upon seeing the sketches, however, Paganini was not impressed. He didn't feel that there was enough flashy, virtuoso passage work. And so they parted ways. Berlioz went on to recast the melodic material to tell a different story. This, the story of Lord Byron's hero, Harold, as he wanders through Italy in Childe Harold's pilgrimage. The part of Harold will be played on the viola by our ravishing soloist, Nokuthula Ngwenyama. First naive, the hero gains strength as he wanders through the countryside, developing in courage and character. He encounters the sacred pilgrims on their journey, and we will hear the tolling of bells. In the third movement, he encounters a pair of lovers, and we will hear the love song voiced by the viola in the serenade. Movement is called the Orgy of Brigands, and here our hero will succumb to secular temptation. Berlioz described it this way: wine, blood, joy, and rage mingle in mutual intoxication and make music together, and the rhythm seems now to stumble, now to rush furiously forward, and the mouths of the brass to spew forth curses, answering prayers with blasphemy as the brigands laugh and swill and strike and generally enjoy themselves. Inspired by Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, we'll hear quotes from each movement before this riot erupts. When Niccolo Paganini finally heard the work that he had inspired initially as Mary, Queen of Scots, he was overwhelmed. Story tells us that he leapt to the concert stage and he dropped to his knees, grabbing Berlioz's hands and kissing it in adoration. He said that this experience of listening to Harold in Italy was one of the most profoundly moving musical experiences of his life. And the next day, he sent Berlioz a thank you letter. Enclosed was a gift of 20,000 francs. On December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, the Santa Rosa Symphony hopes for you to have one of the most memorable musical experiences of your life. We invite you to come to Weill Concert Hall at the Green Music Center. Arrive an hour before, and I will share with you some of the most scintillating and fascinating stories in music history that form the backdrop for the program. I'm Dr. Kayleen Asbo, music historian for the Santa Rosa Symphony. I hope you'll join us on this adventure and a celebration of both the sacred and the secular in this time of revelry during the holiday season. I'd like to extend an invitation to you to come here to the Petaluma Historical Library and Museum for an ongoing series of lecture recitals that explores the hidden connection between music and art and literature join me, Dr. Kayleen Asbo, for Musical Mondays at the Museum.